Logical binary constraints part 2. Suppose a company has 5 projects available to choose from. We define the decision variables as follows. Now consider this requirement. If project 1 is selected, then projects 2 and 3 must also be selected. Think of it as a child invited to a party where both parents must be attending. So the mom or dad may attend without the child, but if the child is going to attend, both parents must be in attendance as well. So X1 depends on X2 and also on X3. We can combine them to give 2X1 less than or equal to X2 plus X3 or 2X1 minus X2 minus X3 less than or equal to 0. That is, we can decide to have none of them. We can have only project 2 or only project 3 or both projects 2 and 3 without project 1. And we can have project 1 as long as we have 2 and 3. We can't have project 1 with only project 2. We can't have it with only project 3 either. And we can't have it by itself. Next, if project 1 is selected, then 2 or 3 or both must also be selected. So we can think of this again as the case where the child can attend the party if at least one of the parents also attends. So X1 depends on X2 or on X3. And we write x1 less than or x2 plus x3, or x1 minus x2 minus x3 is less than or equal to 0. So we can decide to choose none, we can have only project 2 or only project 3, or both projects 2 and 3 without project 1, and we can have project 1 as long as we have 2 and 3, we can have project 1 with only project 2 or with only project 3, we just can't have project 1 by itself. Next. Project 1 cannot be selected if both 2 and 3 are selected. In other words, project 1 is mutually exclusive with 2 and 3 together. This means that if x2 plus x3 equals 2, then x1 has to be equal to 0. In other words, x1 plus x2 plus x3 has to be less than or equal to 2. We could select none. We could select only one of the 3 projects individually. We could select projects 2 and 3 only. Or project 1 with only 2, or with only 3, but we can't select project 1 if both 2 and 3 are also selected. Next, if projects 2 and 3 are selected, then project 1 must also be selected. So if x2 plus x3 equals 2, then x1 equals 1. But because projects 2 and 3 together are dependent on project 1, then x1 plus 1 has to be greater or equal to x2 plus x3. Or x2 plus x3 has to be less than or equal to x1 plus 1. Or negative x1 plus x2 plus x3 has to be less than or equal to 1. So we can select none of the 3, or select only 1, or project 1 with only 2, or with only 3. We can also have all 3, however, we cannot have 2 and 3 without 1. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.